In this video, I'll show you how to maximize the potential of your bench power supply, one of the most crucial tools for any electronics enthusiast. Most power supplies only come with alligator clips, but they often fall short in certain situations. For voltage injection, probes are preferred, and the ones from your multimeter might not fit. And even if they do, without spares, you can't use your meter. Also, sparks may damage your only pair. Moreover, unscrewing the nuts to make them fit can be cumbersome and frustrating. So, let's delve into some common scenarios and alternative solutions. In certain cases, crocodile clips work effortlessly, like when they can be easily attached to a device's battery terminals, just like this Game Boy. You might have seen people using disembodied battery compartments for this purpose, but the drawback is that you need a separate compartment for each voltage. On the other hand, bench power supplies are adjustable, and you can easily see how much current the device is drawing to narrow down the problem. When it comes to voltage injection, using crocodile clips can be clumsy, even though it can work. As you can see, it would be very easy to poke the wrong place. Additionally, replacing an entire wire can be reminiscent of those animated shows with numerous tentacles. You know, the ones your girlfriend, which is exactly why I made these convenient quick swap cables. Links to all parts down below. I've made this simple banana plug attachment. It's compatible with various accessories. For example, I have this probe attachment, but you can also find other things online. You can use this kind of probe attachment for voltage injection, but they're very flimsy. I'll be returning it for a regular set of probes, which I'll modify. The downside to probes is that they keep your hands busy and they're prone to slipping. A solution is to solder wires directly to the injection point using a wire hook or a clip on it, depending on the wire gauge. However, these solutions don't help with powering devices through DC jacks. Regardless, you can still use your power supply to do it, and I'll illustrate a few ways. While soldering wires directly to the DC jack terminals works in most cases, sometimes the device won't work without a plug inserted. Also, it's slow. One method involves finding a matching connector and wiring the power supply accordingly. However, this approach can be error-prone, will ruin a good wire, and there's a risk of wiring it incorrectly. To avoid having to ruin any wires, I've acquired connectors from a universal power brick, and after determining the tip and sleeve, I wired them accordingly. This type of connector is janky. The crocodile clips easily come loose or cause shorts. After wiring it, you can insert it and power on your device. Well, here's a cautionary example. I accidentally wired it backwards. Interesting to have caught this on camera. It was just going to be a warning. Nonetheless, the Game Boy still powers on. Another method involves using a screw terminal 2.1mm by 5.5mm barrel plug, where you can loosen the terminals and insert the crocodile clips. The positive terminal is normally the tip, but using a multimeter to check is strongly recommended. The advantage here is the ability to reverse the wiring by simply inverting the clips, although it may feel slightly clumsy. You can't use this type of connector anymore with this method. Luckily, there are universal connector sets with a 2.1mm by 5.5mm socket at the back. These will fit effortlessly. If you prefer a solderable version, you can create your own attachment with similar functionality. Reversing the wiring is as straightforward as reversing the banana plugs. But there's more, keep watching. Also, please like and subscribe. Anyway, I've developed an overkill solution to address this problem once and for all. It allows me to reverse the connector's wiring in a fraction of a second and always indicates its current configuration. Big shout out to PCBWay for providing the PCBs I needed for this project. I screwed it all up though, and so I had to modify them. And now it looks very sus.
Marcello!
It doesn't even work anymore. I made another one. Let's assemble it and see how it turned out. Let's give it a try and power it on. And it works! This is my first real project. The LED indicates the positive side, and as you can see, flicking the switch inverts it, with the left side denoting the sleeve and the right side representing the tip. Regardless of the method you choose, I highly recommend investing in a good set of universal connectors. You can find a link to the recommended set in the description below. To use it, simply plug a male-to-male adapter into the board, and then you can connect any desired connector. I particularly recommend a wired adapter to avoid any potential damage if the board gets snagged. The LEDs are actually much brighter and intense than the camera can capture. Let's try powering the Game Boy once again, and as you can see, it works. If you're interested in building this setup, you can find the necessary resources in the description below. However, I take no responsibility for any of your actions. If you enjoyed this video, you might also like the one where I fix the Game Gear. Thanks for watching, and I hope you're happy.